Hi, I'm Antonio Locasio, and I'll be talking to you about the work I've done for my licensing thesis during the last year, under supervision of Mauro Haskeliov and Ezequiel Rivas at the National University of Rosario in Argentina. As you can tell from the talk's title, I worked on an effect system based on the algebraic effects approach. Let me start by setting out our motivation. The theory of algebraic effects and handlers has proven to be both a solid foundation for the mathematical modeling of computational effects, as well as a practical framework for the design of programming languages with effect systems. However, the passage from theory to practice presents significant difficulties in two distinct stages. The first one is in the design of a programming language as a formal calculus based on the theory of algebraic effects. One of the most apparent of these difficulties is the treatment of equations, which have often been left aside from programming languages, although there's some recent work looking into ways to remedy this. We did not focus on this particular issue, however, but we did keep in mind another difficulty that is often overlooked, which is establishing how these languages relate to the underlying theory, as very few are given formal denotational semantics. The second stage in which difficulties may arise is in the implementation of these languages, and particularly of their effect systems. It's often the case that a language's underlying formal calculus isn't suitable for a practical programming language, so the language must be modified or extended to make it more reasonable to programmers. As a result, their actual implementation may end up deviating in significant ways from the formal calculus. The inverse problem can also come up. Sometimes, proposed implementations for core sub-languages omit the treatment of advanced features present in the language, preventing these implementations from being extended into a full language. These problems can make experimenting on these languages harder, as even small variations to the formal calculus may be difficult to incorporate into a language implementation. The design of languages that support algebraic effects is far from mature, and much experimentation still needs to be done, as there's still much to be learned. Clearly, having large, feature-rich languages is at odds with the need for experimentation. So, having a small basic calculus with a simple prototype implementation is very important. Our goal, then, was to formulate a simple algorithmic type and effect system for a core calculus with algebraic effect and handlers. By keeping the system's formal description conceptually similar to well-known declarative effect systems, the task of extending the resulting implementation for it to support more advanced features should be straightforward. This is crucial for our approach, in which we set out to have a formal calculus that evolves alongside its implementation. To do this, we introduce Alef, and a basic calculus with algebraic effects and handlers based on F. In Alef, we adapt F's effect system to incorporate effect rows, while keeping its solid semantic foundation and thus overcoming some of the first stage hurdles I mentioned before. The effect rows we use, though not exactly the same, are based on those found in COCA. Alef's algorithmic type and effect system is formulated through the bidirectional typing discipline, thus leading to a direct implementation and effectively closing the second gap between theory and practice I mentioned before. We picked this approach taking as inspiration Frank's success at applying this technique to effect systems. However, the variation of bidirectional typing we used is novel for effect systems because in it, effect information can be synthesized alongside value types. And to make this possible, our typing judgments provide explicit instantiations for the type's effect rows, as I'll explain a little later. As a running example for this talk, let's take a look at our version of the state effect, representing the current state with a natural number. First, we need to introduce the program's effect signature, which in Alef we write like this. This is obviously the usual state signature that consists of the two state operations. Next, we need to introduce a way to interpret these operations. To do so, we define the state handler, or ST, that gives them the standard state carrying function interpretation. Now we'd like to be able to write this handler's type, but before doing so, let's quickly go over Alef's type system. As usual, in this kind of effect systems, Alef's types are split into value and computation types. Borrowing FC's notation, we'll write the former with letters like A and B, and the latter with a line under the letter. Value types that correspond to the values that a program can return include the base types, functions, and handlers, which we will write with this double-headed arrow. Computation types are formed by the type of the computation's return value, alongside an effect row, which we will write as epsilon, containing all the operations that the computation can invoke. For example, the type of a computation returning natural numbers that may invoke the state operations is the following. Here, mu is an effect variable that represents the ambient effects. Each effect row ends in an effect variable that can be instantiated in order to add operations to the row. For instance, if we wanted to add the print operation to this type row, we would need to apply an instantiation like the following one. Here, we are substituting the effect variable mu by a new row that contains the print operation. So, if we apply it, we get the desired type that extends the previous one by adding print to its effect row. In Alef, the order of operations in a row is irrelevant, and an operation cannot appear in a row more than once. Then, a row can be thought of as a set of operations alongside an effect variable. Now, we can write the type of this handler like this. As expected, the handler transforms a computation that invokes the state operations into a computation that returns the state carrying function that handles it. With this handler, we can define a very simple program in which we first set the state to be the number one and then get the current state. We handle this small computation with our state handler we just defined, and finally run the resulting function with an initial state of zero. As expressed in its type, the main computation is pure because both operations are handled by the state handler. We use this kind of effect rows mainly for two reasons. The first one is that they are very easy to implement, and the second one is because of their expressive power, which is added by the effect variables. Let's see this expressivity in our example. Notice how all three effect variables in the state handler's type are equal, particularly the one associated with the resulting function's type must be equal to the one present in the handler's domain. This is because the resulting function may invoke operations that weren't handled by the handler. Then, all instantiations extending the handler's domain must also extend the effect variable, the effect row associated with the function, the resulting function's type. For instance, if we were to apply the state handler to the following computation, in which we additionally invoke the print operation that is not handled by the state handler, we would need to extend the handler's type to add this print operation to its domain. As we are instantiating effect variable mu, this will also be reflected in all other occurrences of this effect row in this of this effect variable in this type. Due to this, the main computation gets the correct type, indicating that it can invoke the output effect as it will. Let's now take a look at how Alef's type system is defined. As a baseline, we define a declarative effect system for Alef, which basically adapts FC's effect system to incorporate effect rows. This is defined in terms of this standard typing judgment, in which we will write this uppercase T to stand both for computation and value types. This effect system is not only a useful semantic foundation, but it's also the conceptual guide for the design of Alef's algorithmic effect system. As I mentioned before, our goal was to formulate a simple algorithmic effect system for Alef. To do so, we made use of the bidirectional typing discipline. Accordingly, we split the typing judgment into two, one for checking and one for synthesis. Both typing judgments will provide an additional output of the explicit instantiations for the types effect rows, allowing Alef to synthesize effect information. Let's look at both judgments. First, the checking judgment takes as input the typing context, gamma, a term and a type T, and if possible, it generates as output the effect variable instantiation sigma needed to assert that this term checks the type T instantiated with sigma in context gamma instantiated with sigma. Similarly, for synthesis, we now only take as input the typing context and the term, and generate as output, if possible, a type for this term and the instantiations sigma needed for this synthesis. We derive an additional checking judgment that does not allow any further effect variable instantiations. This judgment effectively closes all effect rows and is useful for checking annotated terms. This approach of synthesizing effect information through explicit effect variable instantiations make our system types very precise while requiring few type annotations, which are generally only needed for top-level declarations. Let's now take a look at a rule in this system and compare it to its declarative counterpart. We'll take as an example the rule for typing a hinder application. First, the declarative rule is the following, which is just the standard typing rule for hinder application, which I guess most of you are familiar with. Now, for the bidirectional system, we are going to synthesize a type for this term. But to do so, we first need to synthesize a type for the hinder H, generating instantiations eta. Next, we need to check the computation sys type with the domain of the type synthesized for H. For this, we propagate instantiations eta, applying them to the typing context, and generate new instantiations we call sigma. Finally, the type synthesized for the handler application corresponds to the handler's return type after applying to it the effect variable instantiations sigma generated while checking C. As you can see, except for some handling of instantiations, the bidirectional rule follows the same general structure as the declarative one. Let's see how this rule is applied in our example. We'll step through its definition for the application of the state handler to computation C, that is just the one that also invokes the print operation. So, first we need to synthesize ST's type, which we assume part of the context as the one we declared previously. Next, we need to check C's type with the domain of the handler with the domain of the type synthesized for the hinder ST. Now, as C invokes the print operation, in addition to the state operations, we need to extend the checks types row to accommodate this. So we need to generate an instantiation we call sigma that effectively adds the print operation to the check types row. Finally, we synthesize ST's return type after applying to it sigma. Thanks to this, we ensure that both the resulting computation and the handling functions types correctly include the output effect. But Up until now, I haven't mentioned yet where these instantiations that are crucial for the effect system come from. For this, we introduce in the system an effect variable instantiation operation, which we write with this symbol. This operation takes as input two types and generates, if possible, the smallest substitution sigma that, when applied to both types, produces the same result. So basically, this instantiation sigma unifies both types. The main use for this operation can be found in the mode switching rule that basically allows us to go from checking mode to synthesis mode. This rule is basically telling us that for this term to check type T, we require the composition of the instantiations needed to synthesize a type for this term and those needed to unify the synthesized type with the one we are trying to check the term with. As I said before, we introduced two effect systems for Alef. First, a declarative one that serves as a conceptual framework for the second one, the bidirectional algorithmic system. To make sure that all of the declarative system's properties are also valid in the algorithmic system, we establish a correspondence between the two. To do so, we prove that the algorithmic system is both sound and complete with regard to the declarative system. With this, we were able to trivially extend the declarative system's type safety properties to the algorithmic system. As implied by its name, the algorithmic effect system directly describes an implementation. Hence, Alef's prototype implementation is just a translation of the formalism. For example, the function, the Haskell function that implements the handler application rule, the typing of the handler application rule, is the following. As the judgment, the function takes as input the typing environment and the term we're trying to synthesize a type for. So, just like the rule describes, we first synthesize a type for the handler, obtaining both a type and some instantiations eta. Before checking C, we have to handle some possible type errors in case the synthesized type wasn't a handler type, but after that we can effectively check C with the domain of the type synthesized for H. And finally, just like the rule describes as well, we can generate the resulting type, just as specified by that rule above. Okay, in this implementation, we introduce support for user-defined effects, as we saw in the start of the talk with the state effect signature example. Additionally, thanks to the synthesis of effect information, Alef's implementation produces helpful error messages without any extra work. As this is because it can often offer the solution to the type error with the information readily available at the typing judgment. Let's take a look at an example of how this implementation helps us find type errors and solve them directly. So, here we have the Alef code for the example we've been looking at throughout the talk, but there are two type errors in it. We'll run the implementation to find them and to solve them easily. So, we can run the implementation for the first time and find the first type error that is in the state handler's type, which is basically that we declared the type with different effect variables, the one associated with the resulting function and the one associated with the domain. As I explained before, that's incorrect. We can see that the type error is just telling us that. It says clearly that for the term ST, it expected a type with different effect variables, but in its actual type, all effect variables must be equal. So it's very easy to solve this error and run the implementation one more time. And now we are faced with a much simpler error, that is that we just forgot to add the print operation to the main computation type, because this is needed because we are handling a computation that invokes the print operation, which isn't actually handled by the state handler. So we can add it to the types row and run the implementation for one last time and see that it effectively runs as expected, printing the number 42 and returning the value 1. Okay, so let's quickly go back to the presentation. Okay, just a little bit more about the implementation. As this implementation is a direct translation of the formalism, we were also able to test the system's design for some properties such as type safety. For this reason, the evaluator just encoded the language small step semantics. The tests consist of randomly generated Alef programs, generated and checked through quick check. This is particularly useful in our approach, in which the formal calculus evolves alongside its implementation, as the automated tests can quickly reveal design flaws. To wrap things up, let me quickly summarize our work. We've introduced Alef, a small basic calculus with algebraic effects and handlers. By adding effect rows to its types and applying a variation of bidirectional typing in which effect information can be synthesized, we managed to formulate a simple effect system that is both close to the underlying theoretical notions of algebraic effects and handlers and has a direct implementation. For those reasons, we hope that Alef can become a useful foundation for studying and experimenting with extensions to the algebraic effects approach. Thanks.